seen a lot of pain, but I don't wanna write a love song for the world. I just wanna write a song about a boy and a girl. Junkies on the corner always calling my name, and the kids on the corner playing ghetto games. When I saw you getting down, I was you.
Test 1 2 test. Check. Test 1 2. Test 1 2. Check. Check. Test 1 2. Test 1 2. Thanks, Bob. Test 1 2. How's that sound, Bob? Still distortion? Josh, you still here? Check 1 2. Check. Check 1 2.
Your mic sounds very clear with no music.
Okay. I've got the desktop audio off, and the music is in the background. Does the music need to come up or come down? Check 1 2. Check 1 2. 1 2 3. 1 2 3. Check. Down more, okay. Check 1 2, check. Check 1 2, 1 2, check. 1 2, how about now? Can you hear the music in the background? Just barely hear it? How's the level sound? Check 1 2, check. Let me put some more music on here. Here we go. Barely hear the music? Trying to get the proper audio level. Trying to get a happy medium here of music in the background with me in the front. Let's see. Let me get some music going here. Okay, here we go. Check 1 2. Check 1 2. Test. Check 1 2. Music to voice. How does it sound now, Bob? Check 1 2. Test. Check 1 2. Test 1 2. Test. I need some meters on these things.
I rose up with the avenue behind me. From Jamaica, it always works for me. down the street like Lucky LaRue. Got my hand in my pocket, thinking about you. I ain't a hurting nobody. I ain't a hurting no one. There's 300 men in the state of Tennessee. They're waiting to die. They won't never be free. I ain't hurting nobody. I ain't a hurting no one. Six million, 700,000. Someone could take the time to sit down and listen to the words of my song. At the beach in Indiana, I was 9 years old. Heard a little Richard singing Tutti Frutti from the top of a telephone pole.
I wasn't hurting nobody.
I wasn't hurting no one. There's roosters laying chickens, chickens laying eggs, farm machinery eating people's arms and legs. I ain't hurting nobody. I ain't hurting no one. Perfectly crafted popular hit songs, never use the wrong line. You think that waitress could get my order? Back steps, just shucking that corn. That gal's been grinning since the day she was born. She ain't hurting nobody. She ain't hurting no one. I used to live in Chicago, where the cold wind blows. I delivered more junk mail than the junkyard would hold. I wasn't hurting nobody.
Welcome back to Rotor-Talk. My volume is on. I'm here. Oh, let me click the recording. Here we go. Yep, we're recording. Welcome back to Rotor-Talk. We've got a great show. I'm really excited about it tonight. Greetings from the great state of Maine. We've had some awesome flying weather, blue skies, fair winds. It's been awesome. I've been doing a lot of flying. It's been extremely hot, but now we're going to get a break in the weather. It's going to cool off, so we're looking forward to that. Welcome to Rotor Talk. I am your host, Edward Lyons, reaching out to you into the Ethernet, the universe, trying to bring some awesome RC-related flying content to you folks out there. I want to wish a special thanks, or Say a special thanks to Luciano Benente and Vape TV. I've gotten some more pushback about the Vape TV platform, and I want to take another minute to explain a couple things. The first thing is Vape TV graciously offered us this platform to bring Rotor-Talk to you. However, Vape TV is, we're going to be migrating the platform over to, where is it here? Give me just a moment. We're going to be migrating the platform over to Extreme RC TV. And let me just show you their new logo. It's really exciting. Here we go. And this is, we're going to be, like I said, we're going to be migrating to Extreme RC TV. It's going to be a lot easier to gain access. I realize some of you have had a difficult time gaining access to Vape TV. And I have some people who can't even get on, who want to watch Rotor-Talk, but can't even get on to Vape TV. And I'm aware of your concerns. So we are going to be switching to Extreme RC TV platform once that's up and running. And that should alleviate a lot of people's concerns. But I also want to take a moment to say that Rotor-Talk does not condone anything that's harmful to your body, whether it be smoking, drinking excessively, drug use. Rotor-Talk does not condone that and is for a healthy lifestyle. So please don't think that by and through Rotor-Talk being on Vape TV that we condone any types of these harmful behaviors, because we don't. Because I have young adults as viewers, and the last thing I want to do is impress upon them anything that's bad for their health. Okay, so with that said, I just want to get onto some business. We have Peter Ellin from from Ace's Deals on tonight. Peter's going to be calling in, and we're going to be talking to Peter a little bit about Ace's Deals and some other really cool things. He's got the Parrot Disco. He's coming in, going to be coming into inventory. We're going to talk about that and a few other things. I just want to thank some of my advertisers. Let's go back to the desktop here. Bear with me. And go to, here we go. We are at, bear with me here. Here we go. RC Lager. I want to thank RC Lager for their support. RC Lager's been a legacy supporter of Rotor-Talk from the get-go. They make a fine quality product. Check out the Nova X350. That's an awesome quadcopter. By all means, give them a call. Give them a look, a close look at RC Lager. Their customer service is legendary. And I've got great stories about RC Lager. Also, I want to thank Wheat State Hobbies. Bill Roberts over to Wheat State Hobbies. Wheat State Hobbies, your local hobby shop on your desktop. Give them a click. Bill Roberts has run Wheat State Hobbies for almost 4 years now. He's an Air Force vet and he's a pilot, instrument certified pilot. Him and his wife Jenny run, also working full time. He runs his hobby shop full time, raising 3 kids. Let's see. He just moved to a new location. Wheat State Hobby Shop, your local hobby shop on your desktop. Give him a click. I've used them with great success. I just ordered some Traxxas Aton parts, 2 wake-ups and a cup of coffee, and they're in my dooryard, or in my mailbox, as we say here in Maine. And let's see, I also want to thank RunCam. Let's get over to RunCam's website. RunCam's coming out with the exciting new, what is it, it's the Eagle, I think it was called? Yes, the RunCam Eagle. A really new badass FPV camera. Zero latency. Check out RunCam at www.runcam.com. And let me get back to you here. And I just got to say, I acquired this new camera, and I was a little bit, I had some trepidation about it because the battery is internal. Once the battery goes kaput, the camera's no good. So, unless somebody could probably hack it. I got the new GoPro Session, and I gotta tell you, I am impressed all the heck with this thing. There's no waterproof case, it's in its own waterproof case. You just drop it in the water as it is and use it. I've got some really good footage I'll be uploading real soon on that, so you can take a look. But I'm very impressed with that camera. I think it's definitely one of the better GoPros. So, like I said, we've got Peter Ellin from Ace's Deals on tonight. So what I'm going to do, give me a second here, is we're going to raise Peter up. I told him I was going to call him about 10:10, but we're going to be a little early because I'm excited to get him on. So let's give Peter a call. Where are you, Pete? Calling you, Peter. We are in this video call. Okay.
What are we doing here? Yeah? Why don't we keep... Let's try this again. Give me a moment here. Oh, I think... Did I close that out? All right. Peter. There we go. Bear with me here, folks. Wait a few minutes. Let's go to the video of the week. Where is that bad boy? It's right here. This I found quite impressive. Let's see. Here we go. Oops. Let's escape that. We're on desktop? Yeah, we're on desktop. Okay.
Hey everyone, my name is Eric Sturman. I'm the founder of Sturman Aerials. We're out here today filming at Lafayette Point with the Typhoon H. One of the functions that I really like about the Typhoon H is called curved cable cam, which we're going to use to film this beautiful island behind us. So how curved cable cam works is you fly a route, and as I'm going around the island, I'm going to drop my pins. And each pin is going to be the next destination that the Typhoon H is going to go to. And in doing so, it's going to allow me to take control of the camera and really get the unique shot that I want to get. A great thing about curved cable cam is it will remember the waypoints that you did, and you can go back and forth. So if you want to redo that shot multiple times, as long as the drone is flying, you can keep doing it, and you can keep getting different angles but with the same route. To use curved cable cam feature, tap the system settings icon and choose other settings. Turn on advanced mode and tap the return button. Next, tap the task camera icon to select task. Then you will see five functions displayed on the screen. Tap curved cable cam to enter the curved cable cam function. Fly the Typhoon H to a point and tap the plus sign to create a new point and record the current flying position. Fly to the next point and tap the plus sign again to add a second point, and so on. Please make sure the direct distance between any two points is more than 16 and a half feet. The points you set will appear in the top left-hand corner of the screen. Tap the minus sign to delete the last point you created if needed. You can always tap reset to delete all the points created during those flights. Once you set your waypoints, you can tap save to save your current flight point. Next, tap start and slide the icon. Typhoon H will fly back to waypoint 1 automatically. Slowly raise the throttle stick and the copter will fly along the waypoint in order from 1 forward. Slowly lower the throttle stick and it will fly the route in reverse. To allow control of the camera, switch to the pan selection switch to global mode. Now you can control the camera using the right stick.
So that was Rotor-Talk's video of the week. I was quite impressed with the Typhoon H's waypoints and the flying backwards and forwards, being able to use the camera. So I thought I'd share that with you. It's just a useful bit of information. I know some people who are sitting on the fence about the Typhoon H. The Typhoon H is also coming out with the Intel Sense, I guess, which is avoidance technology. Sounds interesting. I've seen it in other platforms. I think Walkerer did it. And it acted kind of funky. It was based on an infrared technology, which I'm sure this Intel sense isn't. I would hope it's not, because it's going to fail right from the get-go. But this particular Waypoint feature looked really interesting. I did get a new Phantom 3 Advanced 2 days ago. I've been as busy as heck, and I haven't even had it. I unboxed it. It's sitting on the kitchen table over there. Haven't even had a chance to do anything with it. Dad's been in the hospital, and I've got some other things going on, but I'm clear this weekend, so I'm going to take it out and fly with it. So let's see if we can raise Peter up. And give me just a moment here. Let's see. Where are you, Peter? And here we go. Let's give him a call. There he is, Peter. Hello, Pete. Can you hear me, Peter?
Hey, can you hear me?
I can hear you. Can you hear me, Pete? Can you hear me, Peter? Lower the microphone by clicking in your URL bar. Hold on. Oh, can you hear me, Pete? Peter, can you hear me? Hello, Peter? Pete, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir, I can.
All right. A little bit of a technical difficulty. We got it under control. Let me set my shot up here. And there you are. You're on. Welcome to Rotor-Talk. Peter Ellin from Aces Deals. It's a pleasure to have you in the house tonight. Peter Ellin is a legacy supporter, advertiser for Rotor-Talk. If it wasn't for Peter Ellin's input and generosity, Rotor-Talk would not be on the air tonight. So I want to say a special thank you to Peter Ellin for your support of Rotor-Talk and the viewers and the listeners. Welcome to my show, Peter.
It is a pleasure to be here, my friend.
Now, I've known you for, I don't know, probably close to a year now. You were a member in my Traxxas Flyers Club, and you were secret, and you were nondescript, and nobody knew who you really were. And then all of a sudden you burst onto the scene, and you burst onto the scene big. But what I want to know is, where did this all start out, Peter? Let's go back in your biography, and let's go start from those mini cars. I want to hear that story again you were telling me about.
Oh, Lord. Approximately, I would say about 18 years ago, we developed the world's tiniest radio-controlled race car. We came out with approximately 8 different styles, and they were no larger than a AA battery. And as a matter of fact, I don't know if you can see it, there is one of them right now.
Wow, that's cool. I remember those.
I'm sorry. Yes, yes. And the packaging, what we did is we created a bubble packaging, and there's the car, the antenna, the bubble cover so you could store it when the kids were done playing with it. But what was really neat is we were able to develop the controller, which was actually the bottom of the package. So when you opened it up, you screwed the antenna in, put your two AA batteries inside the controller, and you had your forward, your backward, your left, right. They were very responsive little cars. They had a range of about 100 feet, which was considered phenomenal. 15 years ago, we demonstrated them at malls. And it wasn't until, I think, about 7 years ago, approximately, we had sold our 500,000th car.
Wow. Wow.
Yep, and it was to a four-year-old. And we made a big deal about it at the show and everything, that he was the 500,000th customer.
Now, you're still not saying technologically no good anymore? Are you still selling those? Or what's
no, we don't sell them anymore. We actually sold the company to somebody else. I'm not sure if he's doing it anymore. And then, you know, the companies overseas started imitating and copying them. So you can go on eBay and get, you know, what's called little RC mini racers. But I'm proud to say we were the first.
Fascinating. Fascinating. Now, let's go from there to the Aces Deals, the inception of Aces Deals. Where did it all start out?
Oh, okay. Well, Aces Deals has actually existed for 20 years, but it wasn't originally known as Aces Deals. When we were selling the cars, we started to expand into RC boats, RC helicopters, RC airplanes. And it wasn't until 7 years ago, we were one of the very, very first distributor dealers for DJI. And when I first flew the Phantom 1, and keep in mind, this is, you know, 6-7 years ago, you know, you're talking 7-8 minute flight time, and that was considered, oh my God.
Right.
You know, great. But the very first time I flew a Phantom 1, I'll never forget, I had a meeting the next day with our staff, and I said, guess what? We're getting rid of the airplanes, the cars, the helicopters. We're going drones. They thought I was crazy. But I called it right. I said, this is going to be the future. And I was right. And Aces Deals, like I said, it wasn't known as Aces Deals. But when my son was born, my 10th child.
Wow, I didn't know you had 10.
Yeah, I have 10. When Adam was born, I renamed the company Aces, which stands for Adam Cody Ellin.
Oh. I named
after my son.
Ah,
okay. Hey, Mom was right. You learn something new every day.
Learn something new every day, yes. All right, so now you started Aces Deals. I guess you've been at it for the drone end of it for how long now?
About 6-7 years now.
About 6-7 years. So you went exclusively drones. You migrated.
Exclusively drones.
Okay. All right.
We got rid of over 200 products. I'm talking ranging from RC boats, airplanes, helicopters, and we went drones. And keep in mind that when DJI came out, there was only the DJI Phantom 1.
Right.
But over the course of the past 7 years, Aces Deals has not only expanded nationally, but globally. And we now represent 9 manufacturers. And we represent 49 different drones.
Right. You've got 4 warehouses across the country.
Yes, sir. 4 warehouses. We have 4 repair facilities. Our repair facilities, like North Carolina, is dedicated strictly to the DJI Phantom 2, 3, 4, and the Inspire. Mm-hmm. That's headed by John, who used to work for DJI. He is a certified DJI technician. And I'm very, very honored to have him on my staff. I've got Don Price, who heads my Oklahoma City facility. I've got my technicians in California and a repair facility in Michigan.
Awesome. Now, Peter just went on vacation, okay? Now, Peter is not the type of guy to just go lounge about on a beach with a beer in his hand or just sit there passively on vacation. Not only does Peter go on vacation, but Peter works on his vacation.
So yes, Peter, but please don't tell the wife.
So why don't you tell us a little bit about this little deal you pulled together while you're out there floating around in the Caribbean?
Well, what we did, we've been working on this for many, many months. We had scored the, I don't know how you want to put it, but we have the ability now, and it will go into full effect within about 2 weeks, where we will be able to ship and set up a facility directly in the Bahamas, and that'll service the South American countries. And in the very near future, we will be shipping to Cuba.
That's awesome. That is really awesome. So you pretty much tied up the Caribbean and parts of Central America, it sounds like.
Well, I mean, you know, there's a lot of companies out there that do what we do, but you have to understand something. In order to be successful in this business, and in any business, it doesn't matter what you do, you have to think outside the box.
Right.
I'm very disturbed at how many dealers are out there that, you know, they think they're going to make $1 million overnight selling drones or, you know, whatever.
Yeah.
Let me tell you something. You can go into Walmart, Best Buy, Sears, PC Richards. Now, I don't know if these stores you know, are familiar to the viewers or listeners out there, but I'm talking locally. You know, people have heard of Best Buy and Walmart.
Yeah.
And they're selling drones, and it kind of cracks me up, you know, that these big box stores are selling the drones because, you know, I was in Best Buy a couple of months ago, and this is when Unique had the Q500 introduced into Best Buy. And the sales kid, he was about, I don't know, maybe 20 years old, okay? And I'm walking by, and he's talking to a customer about the Q500. And what he was telling the customer, he wasn't really answering the question directly. He was skirting it. He was trying to make himself sound knowledgeable, you know, blah, blah, blah.
Right.
I didn't say a word. I was biting my lip. My wife was kicking me in the shin saying, don't you dare open your mouth, you know. And I didn't do that because I was being respectful of the sales kid. Plus, Best Buy was not my office, so I had no right, you know, to interfere.
Right.
When he was done with the customer and he walked away, I walked over to the customer. I did not say I was Peter from Ace's Deals. I didn't say any of that.
Right.
Again, because this was a Best Buy customer in a Best Buy store.
Right.
And I was being respectful of that.
Right.
And so I said, listen, you know, I own one. If you have any questions, I've got it. I've been buying it for a year. And I answered every single question that the gentleman had. I could have easily given him my business card. I didn't.
Right.
Because again, I was being respectful of the Best Buy territory.
Right.
But that's what bothers me the most is, you know, these stores out there selling these products, they're not really knowledgeable when it comes to, you know, the product itself. And so it's very important. What we did is we excelled in the area of customer service, customer support. Very, very important. I think, and this is what we gather from approximately 88% of our phone calls that come into our office per day, and we average about 300 calls a day, my wife and I, our staff.
Wow.
Customers say to us that the number one reason they called us is because, number one, everywhere they look on the internet, we're there.
Yeah.
Number two, what do you call it? All they read about is good reviews and customer service oriented and blah, blah, blah. You see, even though we're a country or a generation, whatever word you want to use, of high tech, you know, everything's email and instant chat and blah, blah, blah. Customers deep down inside still want to talk to a human being.
That's right.
It's that plain and simple. Sure. And, you know, customers have said to me, my God, Peter, I've got to let you go. You've probably got a million customers waiting to talk to you. And I say to them, and I give them all the same answer, and I'm very sincere. You know, when I speak to them on the phone, I go, look, you're on the phone with me. I don't give a damn about anybody else.
Right.
My job is to make sure that you're satisfied with, you know, whatever answers you need to have, you know, answered to your questions. There's no pressure. I don't care if the customer buys it from me or not, because it's happened so many times. And again, it happened today. Customer calls me up. I don't know if you remember me. This is Joe Blow from Texas. I spoke to you about a Phantom 4, you know, 2 months ago. And I'm very honest, and I'll say, listen, I do remember your voice, which I do. I remember voices.
Right.
I may not remember the name, but I remember voices.
Right.
And they go, you know, you didn't pressure me, blah, blah. I want to go ahead and buy the Phantom 4. Well, you're calling at the right time, because the Phantom 4 at $1,399, we give you two extra batteries for free. They lose their minds.
Yeah, yeah.
They lose their minds.
Right.
So that's what's important, Ed. And I can't stress it more than enough. Customer service is very, very important. We are a very customer-oriented company. We are not a small company. And that's the mistake that the large companies make, all right?
Right.
The customer becomes a number.
Yes.
All right? It's that, you know, when I talk to 200 or 300 people a day, I'm surprised I have a voice right now. It
right,
is more.
Right.
But, you know, but that's what I enjoy. I really do. I could retire tomorrow, but I love what I do.
Well, your job's not a job.
It's not.
Yeah.
It's not. And I explained this when I did a conference with dealers I said, you know, guys, remember who put you there. If it wasn't for our customers, Ace's Deals would not exist.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And we thank them for it.
Yep. No, and you put your money where your mouth is, too. You really do. You don't just say it or espouse it. You actually back it up. And with my own personal experience with my Phantom 3, I somehow messed it up. I don't know. Or DJI told me to send it back. I hadn't even had it returned to you. And I know this is not your usual course, but because we know each other, you already had one in the mail out to me before I even had mine in the mail to you, the return. So, you know.
And you know what? And I'll be honest with you. We've done that with customers that I've only talked to once or twice on the phone. But you got to understand something. I spend my life on the phones.
Right.
When I listen to people on the phone, I know. It's almost like I met them in person. You know, right. that impression you get when you meet someone, you go, hey, this is a stand-up guy.
Right.
So, you know, I had a guy, he was 67 years old. He bought an Autel X-Star Premium.
Right.
He said to me, Peter, it's coming up Compass era, blah, 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 blah. He goes, you know, I said, listen, I'm going to send you a return label. Don't worry about it.
Right.
We're going to fix the problem. I turned right around, got hold of my shipping department. I said, send this guy a new Autel X-Star Premium. Now, the reason I did that is because you got to understand, I also have a very good relationship with the manufacturers.
Right.
When this return comes back, and he called me today, Peter, oh my God, I didn't even ship you the Autel yet, and I have another one at my front door. I said,
right.
Because I'm not worried about you.
Right, right.
And that personal touch, the customer was, I thought he was going to cry.
Yeah, right. No.
Please don't cry, because then I'll cry. I'm 55 years old. Please don't do that to me. But see, this is what makes the business worthwhile.
Oh, yeah. Absolutely.
Our customers. And our customers are not customers. They become our family. And that's so important.
Yeah. No, it's true. It's very true. A long time ago, back in the 80s, when all these companies were being bought out by other companies, our very famous person came on and said, what's going to separate one company from the other is customer service nowadays. Everybody's selling the same thing. I can go buy my Phantom in 100 different places. But
that's right.
I'm not going to get the level of customer service that I'm getting with you. And for me, it's worth me paying more. I'm not saying I paid more. I'm just saying I'll pay more for better customer service, you know?
Right.
And a lot
right.
of people, not everybody's that way, but a lot of people are.
Customers say to us, you know, well, you know, I could buy from Amazon, free shipping, blah, blah, blah. And I turn around and go, you know what? Go ahead and buy from Amazon.
Mm-hmm.
See if you're going to get the level of customer service that we provide. All right. It's that plain and simple. And
right.
they realize that what I'm saying to them, I said, I, you know, and a lot of times I'll hear this on a Saturday. I'm open on a Saturday.
Yeah.
And I said, how many people can you talk to on a Saturday
right.
at 3 o'clock in the afternoon? I've even returned phone calls on a Saturday at 6:30 at night.
Right, right.
And
right.
I said, you know, this is what we're all about. You know, they heard about me from, you know, the forums, or they heard about me from YouTube. You know, half these guys promoting me on YouTube, I've never even met.
Right, right.
But they have dealt with me. They've ordered stuff from me. And they were just so impressed with the customer service that our, you know, company provided. They just said, you know, they start doing thank you videos. And before we know it, it's snowballing.
I hear you, man. I know what the difference is. I've bought stuff from these Chinese websites and have just been played games with. If you have something defective, they want you to send a video. Then if they finally agree to do something, it'll be a month before you get it and before you even fly it or whatever. So I know what bad customer service is. And I just soon, like I said, I decided a long time ago, I just soon pay a little extra to get it quicker and to be able to deal with somebody. In my own Phantom story, I had a Phantom 1 when they first came out. I paid $1,000 for it on Amazon. I got it home. I took it out. I flew it. It flew away.
Yeah.
You know, and unfortunately, I was able to get it back. And it landed in the middle of a double yellow line three streets over. No damage. No damage or anything. So I took it home. I boxed it up and I sent it back to Amazon.
Right.
Whereas I could have called you and you could have told me that Ed, you had user error because you didn't calibrate it before you threw it. You know, so therein lies the difference, you know, again, with customer service.
I got and we have customers, Ed, that call us. They didn't buy the drone. That they feel so guilty. They call me and they go, I don't really want to ask you this question. I didn't buy the drone from you. You know, I need a repair. You know, I didn't buy it from you. I should have. I'm like, listen, don't worry about it. I don't care if you didn't buy the drone from me. I will answer your questions. We will do repair work on it. I'm not going to be prejudiced and say, I'm sorry, Ed, but you didn't buy this drone from me. Yeah. You know, so the heck with you.
Yeah, I call that the local hobby shop, and not all local hobby shops, but some local hobby shops you walk into, if you didn't buy it from them, you're getting the cold shoulder and the stink eye until you walk out the door, you know? So.
And there's the mistake they made.
Yeah, they could have turned that customer, they could have turned that person into a customer, you know?
Exactly.
You know, when I was in sales, my motto was, if you're standing in front of me, I'm going to try and sell you something, you know?
So right.
That's the way it is. I got a question for you from Paul Rimmel. You know Paul.
I know Paul.
Okay, Paul wants to know, he says, how old was Peter when he flew his first drone, and what kind of drone was it?
Well, if we go back 7 years ago, I'm 55, so whatever, I can't even add right now.
Let's subtract, it'll be 48,
49.
48.
And the very first drone I flew was the DJI Phantom 1.
And that did it for you, huh?
That did it for me. I walked into the office the next day, had a staff meeting, and said, we're getting rid of everything. I thought they were going to all walk out on me.
So the Phantom 1 was your first, and then so right away you became a distributor, and then it progressed from there. Now, I'm not going to ask you to speak badly of any drone manufacturers out there specifically, okay? In my opinion, Walkera or whatever. But I noticed that you've eliminated some brands from your website.
Listen, I have no problem with being honest, and it's not a bashing of companies. Look, I used to represent 11 manufacturers.
Right.
In the past year, we cleaned house of two of them, the first one being ProDrone. Now, ProDrone was an up-and-coming manufacturer. We met them last year in 2015 when they were getting ready, you know, they were producing and in production testing of the ProDrone, you know, with the foldable arms and, you know, it was supposed to be the ultimate. We were very impressed with the aircraft. But month after month after month of delay, and it got to the point where on May 15th, I produced a video on YouTube where I apologized to the customer directly. We gave a refund to every single person. There was over 300 pre-orders because I was washing my hands of the ProDrone company. Dealers called me up. They were very upset. You know, I'm hurting their business, you know, blah, blah, blah. And I said, look, what we did, and I felt it was the right thing. And if you look at the comments on the video, they were very reinforcement, you know, positive. We were applauded for our decision to drop the manufacturer. And that's what happened, because we're not going to tolerate misleading of our customers.
Right.
That's what it boiled down to.
But now, good customer service, Peter.
Right. Let's talk about Walkera. Walkera, excellent company years ago, but things have happened where they come out with a product, you know, the Tally H500 2 years ago.
Yes.
Fantastic aircraft, but issue after issue after issue. When Walkera turned around to us and wasn't offering or giving us the support they're supposed to give as a manufacturer, especially when it comes to defective merchandise, all right? I'm dealing with it right now. We have a customer that bought a Runner 250. Walkera doesn't want to hear nothing about it, but the thing doesn't work. We removed Walkera from our website, plain and simple.
Yep, no, good call. Good call. I know Walkera had a mass exodus of their top talent, and they all fled to WL, Wei Lee Toys.
Yes.
And unfortunately, and it's a cutthroat environment over there, and the customer suffers, you know?
Right. Yeah. I will say that we have an excellent working relationship with DJI. We have an excellent working relationship with Autel Robotics.
Right.
We have an excellent relationship with Unique.
Right.
3D Robotics, Hubson. I mean, we move product for them, plain and simple.
Right.
Okay. DJI is probably the number one company that bends over backwards for Ace's deals.
Wow.
Bends over backwards, which may sound astounding to some.
Yeah, it does to some people.
All right. Sure. Yeah. But you got to understand, I've been in the RC business for over 20 years. I know how to, and I'm going to use this word, I know how to manipulate manufacturers.
Right.
You see, they need me. I don't need them.
That's right. That's right.
Okay? So if this is going to work as a relationship, number one, the manufacturer has to assure Ace's deals that they have our back. If they don't have our back, when it comes to the customer, let's pick Paul Rimmel. When it comes to Paul Rimmel, I can't have his back, and I'm not going to tolerate that. I'm not.
Watch out, Jim. So, Paul has a question, another question for you. Let me get...
I'm sorry, who does? Who does?
Paul has another question for you.
Okay.
Jake, don't bark. Now's not the time. What do you think the next big advance in drone technology is to come down the pike? And he says, thank you, Peter.
Oh, okay. We are privy, and I'm very fortunate, we are privy to a lot of stuff that's going to be coming down the pike from three different manufacturers, okay? I can't say which manufacturers they are right now because of non-disclosure agreements.
Right.
But I'm going to tell you that the step they are taking is not so much a downsizing in size, all right? But to a certain degree, yes, all right? You're going to see drones that are going to become more advanced technology-wise. We're going to start seeing flight times along with battery advancements within the next year.
Wow.
And then the biggest step is... for lack of a better word, I guess a smart drone, an intelligent drone.
Right.
We're looking at voice-controlled drones.
Oh, interesting.
Okay, but here's what you want to hear, the icing on the cake. We're looking at a drone that not only is voice-controlled, but it's voice-controlled specifically to the pilot. If someone is to steal Ed Lyon's drone and try to use it, if it doesn't recognize the voice, it ain't doing anything.
Now, what happens if I have a cold?
Well, I mean, if you look at speech recognition on a computer, I could have a cold, but the computer still recognizes the algorithms, you know, and the voice, you know, pattern.
Right, right, right. Oh. I kind of knew that. I was just throwing that out there because it just seems right. Funny to me, you know.
Now, suck up some helium. I don't know what's going to happen.
That's a good point. So these are all, these advances in technology are all from no reputable manufacturers we know?
Yes. Yes.
No fringe, what's that website where you get people to give you money?
Kickstarter or Indiegogo? Yeah. No, these are drones coming from manufacturers that are well-known everyday names.
That's thrilling. I think personally, I think in the next, not in our lifetime, perhaps in your son's lifetime, I think there's going to be drone highways in the sky, and you'll have a helipad on your roof or in your backyard, and you'll be your computer. And you'll be
Think, Ed, we're going to see that in the next 15 years.
You think so?
Yes. EHang, the company out of California. Their office in California, but their office over in, you know, Asia.
Mm-hmm.
But we all know EHang is in development with that, you know, drone, a car flyer, you know.
Yep. Yeah.
So, I mean, it's already been produced. I think it's a price tag of $50,000 or whatever. All right. You're going to see that in the next probably 2 to 3 years, going to become more and more, you know, it's going to only be available over there, you know, on a limited, you know, basis. So
I can't see the Chinese allowing all them things to fly around in their airspace. It would drive them crazy, I think, you know?
Yeah, but, you know, like everything else, they'll control it.
Yeah, that's true, too. Yeah. I think before we even get to that, I think there's going to be, I don't know, lawnmower-sized drones that you'll be able to control with your computer to go to CVS or Walmart or whatever, and they'll have a helipad there. It'll land. The clerk will go out and throw your medicine in there, and it'll fly back on top.
I've told thousands of customers since January in phone calls, here's what's going to impress me, all right? I'm waiting for the drone that gets developed that brings me a cup of coffee in the morning. I'll be a happy camper. Plain and simple. Plain and simple.
Well, you have connections in China. Put the word out, you know?
I have already.
Hey, if it could cook me bacon and eggs and home fries and toast my toast, I just might sign up for that. So that all sounds very interesting. Let me see if I get any more questions for you. Wow, Paul Rymel says this is good stuff. He's quite impressed. Let's see. We're going to take a – Peter, can you mind holding over for a few more minutes?
Sure.
I'm going to take a break and thank some of my sponsors. Hang tight there. I'll be right back with you, okay?
You got it, sir.
All right. And Vape – excuse me. Here we go. Rotor-Talk wishes to thank RunCam for their support. RunCam makes video cameras for FPV flyers, for all kinds of drones. When I started this program, RunCam was very excited, very supportive. They sent me a bunch of cameras to give away. I still have a bunch more to go. I'm going to be giving those away. So I want to thank RunCam very much for their support. I also want to thank Raycon Heli and Quark Dung. Quark has agreed to give away a Traxxas Aton carbon fiber frame on one of our upcoming shows. He's very excited about Rotor-Talk and very happy to be a sponsor on Rotor-Talk. So again, I want to thank Quark Dung over to Raycon Heli. And Wheat State Hobbies, Bill Roberts over to Wheat State Hobbies, your local hobby shop on your desktop. Impeccable customer service, legendary customer service on par with Ace's Deals, Traxxas, Wheat State Hobby Shop, your local hobby shop on your desktop. Give him a click and do business with Bill. Bill's a good guy out there in Derby, Kansas. And let's see, we just want to make sure. Again, I want to let people know, because I just got a message from somebody else, and I'm not going to mention any names. Vape TV does not condone smoking, drinking, alcohol, or drug use. Vape TV, Rotor-Talk was given this platform generously by a fellow RC pilot, Luciano Manente, to bring Rotor-Talk to you on Vape TV's platform. We are migrating to Extreme RC TV. That'll be up in a couple weeks. But again, Rotor-Talk does not condone smoking, vaping, or any kind of harmful activity to one's body, okay? So please, you know, I understand your concern. I agree with you. And please don't let it reflect negatively on Rotor-Talk. I am not against vaping. It helped me quit smoking cigarettes. So we each have our own issues and how we choose to deal with them. But again, Rotor-Talk does not condone smoking or drinking or drug use or any type of harmful activity to one's body, especially my young viewers out there. Yes, you, Adam, I know you're watching. Don't smoke, don't drink, don't take drugs, okay? So that's all I'm going to say about this. Like I said, they were very generous. To stream a program like this costs a lot of money. Without Vape TV, I wouldn't even be able to bring this content to you. So, again, thank you very much to the engineers at Vape TV, Luciano Manente, and Vape TV in general. And just hang in there, folks. We are migrating to Extreme RC TV in the next couple weeks. It'll be much easier for people to get on the program, to interact with the program. We'll have some other features. We'll be streaming directly to Facebook and other platforms. So hang in there. It's going to get a lot better because it can't get any worse. So anyway, we're going to go back to Peter Ellin. Peter, you there?
Yes, sir, I am.
All right. I'm going to see if we got any questions for you here. Let's see. somebody. I have a chat room here on the Rotor-Talk platform where people can ask questions like Paul Rimmel, and I'm just updating it, and there we go. Now, let's talk about, I saw you just put out, you're taking pre-orders for the Parrot Disco.
Ah, yes.
Let's talk about the disco. Let's start from what you know, when you anticipated on getting them, and let's go from there. All right, go ahead.
All right. Well, the Parrot Disco, as you know, is not a drone in the sense of the word. It's a fixed wing. We decided to carry it, and we represent Parrot. We've been working with Parrot for a while. You know, we have the Parrot Bebop 2, which is on promotion from them. But the disco is something very, very unique. There's a couple of similar, you know, items out there that we're aware of. But Parrot really did a nice job with this one. You know, we're looking at a 45-minute flight time, a 2-kilometer range, very durable, very stable. But the package they put together for the consumer at $12.99, you know, you're getting the fixed wing disco, you're getting the controller.
What's the wingspan on that? Do you know?
I just looked at the specs this afternoon. I know it's less than 3 feet. I'm sorry, I don't remember exactly what it is. I don't have the spec sheet in front of me.
That's okay. I'm looking it up right now.
Oh, okay. But the goggles included with it is a phenomenal addition to this package. It will be available without the goggles, but Ace's Deals will only be carrying, you know, the full kit and caboodle with the goggles, because there's been a high demand for it. Parrot has already indicated to us that they have shipped to us. We are expecting them sometime next week. We've taken already several pre-orders.
This is exciting. This is very exciting.
Yeah. And then, so we plan on shipping the week of Labor Day weekend.
Wow. Wow. That's awesome.
Parrot's not fooling around.
Yeah, really. I've got it up on screen here at the Aces Deal site for the viewers and the listeners to see. Well, the listeners can't see it, obviously. It looks like quite the bird. Have you been able to see one up close in person, or?
Yes, I did. I was very fortunate. As a matter of fact, it was late as last week, and I was rather impressed. I can't wait to fly it. Wow! I can't wait to fly it.
So now the goggles, are they like a fat shark or?
I would say they're a little bit better than the fat shark. I love the fact that you can wear glasses with them. I'm 55 years old, blind as a bat, so I need to wear glasses. the view from them was astounding, very, very clear, and it's the people who are going to get this bird are going to be rather impressed with it. They are. The telemetry is right there on the screen. Accessories like batteries, propellers, wings, if you break a wing, they'll be available within 2 weeks in our warehouses, you know, right after the delivery of the Parrot, you know, disco.
Right.
But, you know, we're very excited about it. We really are.
So now what is it made of?
It's an advanced form of EPO foam that you see on, you know, the new RC airplanes, that foam.
Yeah.
But it's a much more advanced state of polystyrene type. You know, very, very hard. It's, you know, it's not easily breakable unless you did a head-on collision, you know, into a solid brick wall.
Right.
But it's very well made. It's very well constructed.
So from what I'm looking at, so the wings aren't integrated into the airframe there. They're pushed in or assembled, correct?
Yes, sir. They're pushed in and locked.
Wow. This is exciting. This is, I've not really been a big, big fan of Parrot, but boy, this thing is really, really looks, I hope it performs as well as it looks, because it looks just amazing. It really does.
Well, you know, when you said, you know, you weren't impressed with Parrot, I agree with you. If you go back a year or two with the Parrot Bebop, I wasn't we weren't impressed with the Parrot Bebop and the other stuff that they were selling in Apple stores and stuff like that. But this new generation of Parrot stuff that's coming out, the Parrot Bebop 2, if you ever get a chance to fly one of these, they are phenomenal.
Really?
Right now, Parrot has the Bebop 2, you know, version 2, which is $599. The controller is like $259, whatever.
Right.
But right now, they bundle the entire package. It's on our website until August 31st, $599 for the entire package. But what impressed me is when we flew the Parrot Bebop 2, very, very stable, very responsive. The features it has is incredible. I didn't know it, but the Parrot Bebop 2 comes with two batteries, not just one.
Oh, wow. Wow.
And it was really, really cool. And we already have customers asking us for Weep 3D print accessories for the Parrot Bebop 2. And, you know, they wanted something to store propellers in. So we designed a 3D printed case that holds, you know, the tri-propeller, you know, with the three blades.
Yep, yep.
So we made a case with a lid, 3D printed, that stores all four propellers. And they're going to be on our website by tomorrow. Oh. And already, I mean, customers are like, wow, they love it. You know, 3D printing opened up a big, you know, world for us. But let's get back to the Parrot for a second. The Parrot Bebop 2, phenomenal aircraft. A very big improvement over the Bebop, the original. You've got the Disco coming out. On August 30th, Aces Deals will be announcing another drone from Parrot. Okay?
Really?
Yes, sir. Now, I'm going to spoil a little bit. All right?
Okay.
You are going to be looking at a drone. It is called the Parrot Swing. Like a child's swing.
Right.
And when you see it, and you can Google it now, pictures are just starting to appear. The Parrot Swing. This is going to be a drone that will retail for $139, and it looks like an X-Wing fighter in a way because of its design.
Oh, my God. I got one right here. Hold on just a minute. I'm pulling up. Oh, my God.
Now, I'm not allowed to...
Rotor-Talk land? Look at that. That is that's crazy.
Your viewers are the very first to hear, basically, from us that we will be releasing this on August 30th. It will be on our website, and the price, from what we understand, is approximately $139.
Wow, that thing looks insane.
Yep.
So it'll fly forward, and it'll fly like a quadcopter. Is that correct?
That's right.
Wow. You're
talking about making a drone and an airplane at the same time.
That's like that startup company that Shark Tank did. I can't remember
the name. That's right.
What is that?
No, I'm saying that's right. I remember that.
Yeah. Are you dealing with them at all?
No.
They seem to have gone by the wayside since they burst onto the scene. I haven't.
Yeah.
Haven't seen or heard anything
from them. You get a ton of money and then you waste it in the wrong areas. And your money dries up, you can't go forward because nobody's going to give you more money.
Boy, ain't that the truth. Ain't that the truth. Well, that's really exciting. So August 30th, you'll be announcing that you have them or that you'll have them?
No, that we will have them because they will be on their way also. I think Parrot will be shipping them to us within, I think, 5 or 6 days after the official announcement.
Wow, that's awesome. Very exciting. That's a very unique looking drone. Really excited to see footage on it of it flying, you know, taking off and landing and then flying like, you know, going from a quadcopter to a plane.
Well, get ready, boys and girls, because Jim Bowers of YouTube, Demon Seed, will be doing an unboxing and a preview, a review on the Parrot Disco. He's going to be doing it on the Parrot Swing.
Right.
So it's going to be exciting.
Now, getting back to the Disco, if you're not a pilot of a fixed-wing airplane, what is going to make you want to buy this and fly this? Is there some type of, you know how Blade has the safe technology. Is there anything like this in the disco?
Well, yes, sir, because what Parrot considered was the market of the inexperienced or the noobs or the very first-time beginner. That's why they made it so simple that when a customer takes it out of a box and he's never flown anything, he charges it up, blah, 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 the app, you know, all of that good stuff. And the fact that you can just hand launch it, you can't get any easier.
Wow.
And then landing, there's two landing modes. You can, you can have it land, you know, where it comes in like an airplane on a runway.
Right.
Or you can just hit auto land and it will cut the propellers in midair and then spiral down to the ground.
Oh my God.
Circles. That's, I mean, come on.
Really?
You can't make it any easier.
I know. That's awesome. That's very exciting. I'm very, very anxious to see that thing.
And that's the market that they were looking at. They weren't so interested in all of us out there that, you know, been flying drones and, you know,
right.
Have every drone in our closet.
Right.
They're going after another market besides, you know, us.
Right.
But they're going after the consumer. Look, you got Christmas coming up.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
When the videos start coming out from us and everything else, you're going to have the wives that are going to be buying it for their husbands, yeah. You know, for, you know, whatever.
Yeah. Well, very exciting. Now, getting back to the Parrot Disco. So there's like a safe technology in it for beginner pilots, so they'll be able to fly it?
Yes, because you're going to have modes where you can, you know, control the speed, or you can go into fast mode. You're going to have a beginner, intermediate, advanced.
Okay, because I know like on my apprentice, I can't roll that thing over in beginner mode. I can't do a corkscrew or a 360 or anything. It won't let me do it. Which I think is really good because it helps teach you how to fly, you know, which you don't need a buddy box or some RC pilot that, you know, coach you along, so to speak. So I really like that aspect of that. So that's very, very exciting that they're going to be doing that, make it accessible to not only advanced pilots, but the new pilot out there, too. So that's
right,
awesome.
Because that's a very large untapped market.
Yeah, for sure. Now, I just want to ask you one other question. What do you know? I know that Traxxas is working on a hobby grade or hobby style transmitter for their quadcopters, for like the
Alias
and the Aton. What do you know about a hobby style transmitter from Traxxas? Do you know anything about that?
Traxxas has been very tight lipped
mm-hmm.
as far as that, you know, item is concerned. Mm-hmm. It's definitely in the works. It's definitely in production. I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see it, and this is just based on drips and drabs, you know, my moles. I wouldn't be surprised if we didn't see it. I would be surprised if we didn't see it by Christmas. And when I say Christmas, I'm talking mid-October, beginning November.
Well, the Aton was supposed to be out for Christmas, too.
Right.
You know, so... I hope so. I'm just curious if they're going to ship it with new Atons or if they're going to make you buy it after the fact, or I'm just curious what's going to happen there.
If they follow suit like all the other manufacturers do where they release something, they release it as part of the drone kit and then make it available separately down the road.
Yeah, because I know there's a lot of people who would have bought an Aton if they had provided a transmitter that was suitable for their needs, you know, hobby style. But Traxxas explained it well to me. There's over 100 million gamers on the planet, and there's probably maybe a million RC pilots on the planet. So, you know, they were going after the mass market, which makes sense.
That makes perfect sense. And my Traxxas rep has told me the same thing, and I agree with them.
Oh, yeah, I do, too. I agree with
people
you.
Call me up and they say, oh, you know, why doesn't Unique do this with the Typhoon H? Because what you're asking for, and again, this applies to the Traxxas, I don't want to buy an Aton until they come out with a blah, 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 you know, controller.
Right.
If because they only represent 2% of the market.
Mm-hmm.
And they're not going to spend millions of dollars, you know, R&D for that 2%.
Right.
They're interested in the 98% that takes it out of the box and flies.
Exactly.
And they reach their goal.
Yes, yes. For me personally, it's not a problem. It doesn't bother me. I don't care. I'm an RC pilot. I'm happy as long as I'm flying. I don't care if I'm going to use 2 matchsticks and a matchbook to fly. I don't care as long as I can fly.
But see, you know, and I said to a customer one time, he says, well, you know, the Traxxas Aton, you know, it's like a toy controller. And I said, what do you expect for $399?
Yeah, right. Exactly.
And you know what? He said to me, he goes, you know what, Pete, you're right. I said, you know, these pilots are complaining. You know, they want a $7 million remote.
I know.
For $399.
Yeah, I know. I know. Traxxas got to make some money, too. You know? They're going to make a profit, or else they're not going to be putting these things
out. Look, I'll tell you something. I've looked at a lot of drones that were in the $300, $400 class that were pieces of crap.
Oh, yeah.
But when it comes to the Traxxas Aton, I have to tell you, that's one nice bird.
Oh, absolutely.
You know, plain and simple.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I love mine, so I'll never get rid of mine, that's for sure. So let me just see if I got any other questions here for you, Peter. Let's see. No, I think that's good. I think that's good. Okay, so I just want to let people know, my viewers know, and my listeners know, that I still have the Aces Deals racing quadcopter that we're going to be giving away. And Peter has also generously offered to give away a Marco Polo. We're going to be giving that away in the next couple weeks. And we're going to be bringing Peter back for recurring visits. And Peter's going to come back with coupon codes and things like that. Tonight is mainly an introductory. We all know who Peter is, but we're not all of us have talked to him. And it's good to put a face to the name. So that's one of the reasons why I bought Peter on tonight. Plus, he's a hell of a nice guy, and he's been really supportive of all of us. So he deserves this spotlight tonight. And let me just see if there's
I want to say something before we close, but go ahead, Ed. Sorry.
Yeah, go ahead.
All right. What I want to say, first of all, is number one, thank you, Ed, for, you know, having me on the show. I had a lot of fun. I could have been sitting in a bar, you know, with a bunch of women, but instead I chose to spend my time with you. So I thank you for that. Number two, I want to thank the listeners, the viewers, whether you're customers of ours or not, you know, for tuning in, taking the time, you know, to spend, you know, the time with us. You know, it's 11 o'clock at night here in New York. You know, you could be doing something else, watching King of Queens, whatever. but I did stand-up comedy 20 years ago, but yeah, that's another story. But anyway, I want to thank the viewers and, you know, the people, whether or not, you know, they've been to our website. But what I'd like to do is extend an invitation. Come and visit us, you know, at www.acesdeals.biz. If you ever have any questions, people, I mean, we're here 6 days a week. As you gathered, I'm very, very customer oriented. Call me up if you have just a question. I'm not looking to sell you something. You know, I don't care. I'm here to, you know, help you guys. And you can reach us, you know, toll free at 888-239-2644 or 631-730-7228. Before I close, I want to throw out a coupon code. This is a thank you for all the people that listen tonight. This coupon code will be good until December 31st of this year.
Awesome. Awesome.
The coupon code can be used as many times as you want. That means if you place an order today, you place an order next week, you place an order 3 months from now, you can use the same coupon code. The coupon code is transferable. You want to give it to your aunt or uncle. Hey, you know, Aunt Mary, buy me this, you know, little mini trainer drone for me for my birthday in September. Give her the code. It doesn't matter. The code is going to be simple, and it'll give you a percentage off your entire order.
Okay.
And the computer will assign that percentage. So, but your coupon code for your listeners, your viewers out there, will be simple. In small letters, Rotor-Talk.
All one word?
All one word, small letters.
Okay, I'm posting that on the chat link now so people know that.
All right, and, small letters, Rotor-Talk, R-O-T-O-R-T-A-L-K.
Got it. And the chat room has got it, and I'll post it along. What I'm going to do is, this is the first recorded show I've done. I could manage to remember to record it. So this is going to go out on all the social media sites and everything. And is it okay to include the coupon code with that?
Absolutely.
Okay, so I'll include it with the link to the show. And I think that's it, Peter. I think we're all done. We ran a little late, just where it's 11:05, I think. Yeah, 11:05.
Well, that's okay. I missed Hogan's Heroes, but I'm not gonna hang you for it.
Well,
so.
I want to ruin it for you, but Schultz still knows nothing. So I want to again thank Peter Ellin for joining us tonight on Rotor Talk. It was a very great visit with him. If you have any questions, pick up the phone and call Peter. Not now, but during normal business hours, pick up the phone, call Peter. If you don't get Peter, you get his lovely wife, Jan. I think she knows a little more than he does, but don't tell Peter I said that. And feel free to give him a call. Any questions, any concerns. The guy is very accessible, very friendly, as you can see and hear. So don't hesitate. It's www.acesdeals.biz. B-I-Z. I make that mistake. I keep typing common. It's B-I-Z, www.acesdeals.biz. Feel free to contact Peter. Peter, I want to again say a special thank you to your invaluable support to Rotor Talk. I want to again say thank you for your invaluable support of all my social media and Facebook sites and clubs and groups. You truly are a pilot's pilot. You're a fellow pilot, and you're in it for us. And that's really refreshing. After being burned so many times buying these cheap Chinese quads off these Chinese sites, it's good to deal with somebody who speaks the language and who's very responsive. So, again, I want to thank you, Peter, for joining us tonight. We look forward to having you on again.
Pleasure. Definitely our pleasure. Thank you.
Okay, any last words from you? I'm going to give you the last word, my friend.
Good night, everybody. Happy flying. Stay safe. And enjoy the rest of the summer.
All right, now that was Peter's Ellin from Aces Deals. Thank you for joining us tonight on Rotor Talk. We'll see you next Friday night, 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. Again, thanks for visiting us on Rotor Talk tonight. The platform, like I said, is going to be changing to Extreme RC TV. We got some even bigger, better things coming. We're going to start the giveaways next week, and we're going to go forward from there. So again, thank you for joining us tonight at Rotor Talk. This is Ed. Ed Lyons, your host, over and out. All right, Peter. Thanks, my friend.
You got it, my friend.
All right.
All righty.
Thank you again. Good night.
Good night, Ed.